Good afternoon. I'm back today to the very first Rudolph's Mountains movie, back to episode 2. Only this time I'm hoping to go the right way to Maesglase instead of the wrong way. I'm coming from the other side this time, and wow, is it beautiful. Forecast is supposed to be dry, but it's looking like there's showers about, and now that could be a problem, which I'll talk about a bit later. Anyway, let's get cracking and get on up the hill, because time is tight. Oh, well, that lovely track we've been following on the way up has disappeared now at the head of the valley, and now it's going to get really steep, so it's really boggy here too. So in a minute I'll stop and take my jacket off, ready for the steep climb up. I was just popping the Gertie back in the loop on me. Have a second. Got Gertie's big hairy muff in my mouth. Whew. Anyway, enough about that. Today's trip up Maesglase may or may not be successful for a couple of reasons. One, I didn't start out until 3:30, so limited amount of daylight, so I've got 3 hours and then need to turn around. And the other is because I was packing in a bit of a rush, I forgot to bring my waterproof jacket. Oh, an idiot. It's not the end of the world, because I have got an emergency shelter and a windproof and a couple more layers. But if I have to shelter out of a heavy shower for half an hour in my shelter, then I'm not going to be able to make it to the top, because I won't have time. Anyway, wow, it's absolutely beautiful, absolutely beautiful. What a great area. So I'm making good progress, I think. Lost the path a couple of times coming up that steep section, but found it again shortly after. And now the next bit is climbing alongside this forest, so I'll update you again at the top of there. Wow, that was tough coming up alongside that forest. So steep and slippery. Anyway, the path we're after for Maesglase now, forks off to the right here. Can't see at the moment, but I'm sure if I head that way, I'll pick something up. Wow, that waterfall down there was fantastic, absolutely beautiful. And a little outcrop that you can get some, hopefully some great footage, thanks to Daisy. We shall see. But I'm a bit miffed because it's been raining on and off for the last 20 minutes. And that wasn't in the forecast. Hello. Well, the rain's just got a lot heavier, and so I'm just hiding in my shelter for hopefully it'll be a few minutes, and then we'll carry on. Oh, right, shower didn't last long, only about 5 minutes, and we're off again. But looking around, you can just see that there's still plenty of more showers about. And if I've got to stop every few minutes to dive into my shelter, that's going to be really frustrating. I've been going for 2 hours. I'm not a million miles away from the top. It's definitely doable, provided the weather holds. But my it's an hour till turnaround time. So I'm going to, when I can, I'm going to push on as fast as I can. In the shelter again. Not happy. Let's see how long this one lasts. Oh my, that was a much longer shelter. I was like toast in the shelter. As soon as I've come out, oh, I'm freezing. It does look clear in some ways, and horrible in others. So I'm not sure what I'm going to get. I think speed is of the essence. But I'm nearly at the top of Maesglase, as it's indicated on the OS map, which is where I went last time, which isn't the highest point. Highest point's a bit further along, so shall see you over there shortly. Right, this is main do. What I thought was the top of a Maesglase, but it isn't. Because the actual top which we're going to go to now is Craig Rhiw-erch, which is over there. So let's go and bag the proper top of Maesglase, as I should have done a couple of years ago. Right, this is the top of Craig Rhiw-erch, I think. It's hard to tell, it's not marked on the OS map. There's a little cairn down there, which I'm guessing marks the top. You look over to Main Do now and it looks like there's absolutely nothing in it. Although it did feel like you were coming uphill, coming here, but when you look back, it's so deceptive, isn't it? So deceptive. There's a couple of other tufts of grass here, which I'm gonna go and stand on. Because I don't have to come back a third time. Mind you, it's been no hardship because today has been an absolutely stunning route. Gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. Weather's been very unpredictable, but it looks like it's going to stay dry for a little bit. The wind's probably okay for Daisy, so I'll cut to Daisy now to give you a quick summit tour. Daisy, it's over to you. Thank you, Daisy. Right, I'm not going to hang around up here. It's taken 2.5 hours for me to get up, which is half an hour within my turnaround window. But if I dilly-dally too much, I'm going to quickly eat into that. And also, I've actually brought some tea with me. It's about 6-ish now, so maybe we'll get off the top here, try and get somewhere a bit sheltered, and then we'll have our tea. It should be fab. Whew. Right, I got a little bit chilly mucking about with Daisy on the top there. Right, I'm back at Main Do. If you do come up Maesglase from the other direction where I did in episode 2, it is worth coming over here because the view from Main Do is just absolutely beautiful. It's stunning. Oh, I love it. Very dramatic cliffs down this side. I was trying to find a circular route and I looked at trying to go down the ridge down there. But how you get across the valley at the bottom to pick up where I left my bike, I wasn't too sure. They did look like a potential route, but I think it went through some through a farm. I'm not entirely sure whether that had a public right of way, and that could have been a bit awkward. So I'm going back the way I came up, and it's actually brightening up a little bit now, which is great. It's half an hour since I left Craig Rhiw-erch. I made really good time. Actually, had a little run for part of it. And now I'm regretting it because my knee's killing me. Oh dear. Joys of old age. Your brain thinks you can do one thing and your body says something else. Coming down's been interesting.
I was heading for the path that runs alongside the forest, the one that I followed on the way up. And I found a path that runs parallel to about, what, maybe 70 or 80 feet from the tree line. And I was a bit worried about that tree path because it was all grass and wet grass, steep wet grass, is a little bit treacherous. This path that I've been following has been still really steep, but a bit more stony. And overall, I would say better as a descent route. Say not new and flying. It is fairly overgrown in places, but still passable. And so, at some point here, I'm going to intercept the tree line. It'll be interesting to see where that point is. I'll put the camera away, I need my sticks. It's fair to say this path is a little overgrown. That's probably why you don't see it on the way up. It's because of the bracken. You know, in the winter it'd be actually easier to find. The bracken's probably as big as it gets at this time of year. Right, I'm back off the steep section now. My little body is paying for the pace coming down. Oh dear. Anyway, now it's time to find somewhere for my tea. Right, just got to wait 8 minutes now and then my dinner's ready. Not bad. Pasta al funghi. Would you believe it? Seems like the weather's not quite finished with me yet. Well, that was that. Enjoyed my tea. And the adventure's pretty much over, really. We've got about a 20-minute walk down this path back to Nuttall. And then the lovely ride back into Dolgellau, back to Caroline. So, yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this. It's been a bit of a rushed afternoon, but I've really enjoyed it, and it's been great to bag Maesglase after all this time. So if you're still with us, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next episode.